The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Excel 2016 in depth in full color with the free content update program. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1959. Vote for Excel changes with User Voice. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Chillen. Well, today I have a rant about pivot tables in Excel. I love pivot tables, but ever since Excel 2007, every time that I create a pivot table, I'm very annoyed that if I choose multiple fields in the row area, right? See, they all show up there in column A, and this is hideous. I mean, it's great if I'm going to be doing this live at a staff meeting or something like that, but the fact is, I am going to reuse this data later, and having three different fields in column A is the worst thing ever. So ever since 2008, I have been lobbying the Excel team to say, look, I understand you love your compact form here, but there's a lot of us who need tabular form, and in fact, what we really need is flat, which is the Excel power pivot way of creating a pivot table. Every time I create a pivot table, I come in here and go back to tabular form, and then frankly, I go to repeat all item labels. All right, this gets me a data set where each field is in its own column. Region in A, product in B, customer in C. That's the way it should be, and if you agree with me, I feel your pain. But up until this point, all we've been able to do is just gripe about it. Once a year, I'm out in Redmond and I talk to the Excel team. I say, you know, we really need to have under Excel options a way to say what the default for future pivot tables is. And they say, yeah, we'll get to it sometime. Well, I was just out at Redmond, and I just went through that process again, and I learned about this amazing, amazing thing. All right, so right now, look up in the upper right-hand corner of the screen, that little eye, that's called a card. Click there, and you'll get to this blog post about User Voice. And then right here in the third paragraph is a link that you can hardly see, to where I posted my idea at User Voice. And what is User Voice? Excel.uservoice.com is not a Microsoft site. This is a site, though, that the Excel team is paying attention to. The idea is, you have an idea for Excel, you come out to Excel for Windows, the desktop application, type up your idea, right? And then you start to tell your friends and coworkers and other people who use Excel about your idea, and they can vote. Here's the rule. If Microsoft sees an idea with 20 votes, they're going to personally respond. All right, so here we go. I actually have a response from the Excel team for this. And if you get many more than 20 votes, then they're actually going to consider using it. All right, now when the Excel project manager told me about this, well, you need 20 votes, I just laughed. I said, everyone wants this. I'm not going to get you 20 votes. I'm going to get you 1,000 votes. All right, so hey, here's the thing. If you agree with me that this should be a setting that should change, I want you to come out to excel.uservoice.com and vote for my idea. But you know, the problem is, even if Microsoft does this in a year, then it's up to your IT department to decide to install the new version, so you're 3 years out. Beautiful thing is Debra Dalgleish over at contextures.com has a beautiful add-in called Pivot Power Premium. Pivot Power Premium lets you do this right now. Pivot Power Premium lets you change this setting right now for all future pivot tables and gets rid of all sorts of other annoyances. I love this add-in from Debra. So now, rather than just griping about the idea, we have two possibilities. First possibility is go vote to lobby the Excel team. Second possibility is just go give Debra $30 or $59, depending on which version, and have the problem fixed right now. But whether you buy Debra's add-in or not, I really want to convince the Excel team that this one setting should be changed. And so I'm not above bribing you to vote. All right, if you go out to excel.uservoice.com, you vote, send me a screenshot showing that you voted. The address is right there on the screen. I'm going to do two things for you. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to send you a link where you can download my full color, two-page laminated Excel pivot tables tip card with all of my favorite pivot table tricks and tips right now for free. There you go, buying your vote. Also, if you do this in the next week before the 15th, I'll send you a great coupon code, a secret coupon code from Debra, where you can save 20% on her Power Pivot Premium. But the really, really important thing here, whether you are annoyed by this pivot table setting or anything else in Excel, is to come out to excel.uservoice.com, where you can communicate directly with the people who create Excel. lobby support, get votes for your idea, and they're going to respond. Hey, to learn more about pivot tables, click that little I in the top right hand corner right now and you'll go to my complete playlist about pivot tables on YouTube. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast. Mr. Excel. MrExcel.com.